So at the end of the discussion, you're expected to discuss the meaning of the teacher as a professional, then explain what society demands from teacher as a professional. And you're going to explain the professional competence that a teacher should possess. Well, we all know that teaching is the noblest of all profession. It is considered as the noblest of all profession, and it is placed in the pedestal of all profession. That is why much is demanded from being a teacher. So teachers spend at least 6 hours a day and 5 days a week in 10 months of the school year with the students. That is before pandemic, and because of that length of time, practically the time spent by the children, the waking hours of the children is spent in school is more than the waking hours spent by the children at their home. So, practically speaking, most of the time, the children are with the teachers. So teachers really affect the behavior, the character, and the attitude of the student, pupils, or children more than their parents. They have a tremendous power to influence the student, and society as a whole expect much from teachers and the school. As I have said during our previous discussion, that even though you commit a mistake not connected to your official functions or duties, because you are or you belong to a teaching profession, you can still be held administratively liable, or you can still be disciplined. Because at all times, teachers must possess dignity. And we are considered as a model in the society. So we are not allowed to commit even the slightest mistake. That is the price of being a teacher. So when the young do not behave as expected, the question is raised by the parents. Yan ba ang natutunan mo sa school? Yan ba ang natutunan mo sa paaralan? Marunong ka nang sumagot? Diba? Yan yung palaging naririnig natin sa ating mga magulang kapag sinasagot natin sila. So, scholar expected to work with and for the communities, so as the teacher. So teachers play different roles in the society. Merong ang post sa Facebook, nakita nyo. Teacher, minsan teacher, minsan mentor. Minsan teacher, minsan PDA, kasi may mga teachers na nag-lecture about the effect of the drug abuse. Minsan teacher, minsan COMELEC, kasi we are always staff as members of Board of Election Inspector or Board of Election Tellers during the election. And minsan teacher, minsan gardener. You're also expected to beautify the surroundings of your classroom, of your school. What else? Minsan teacher, minsan event coordinator during the fiestas. So you can just imagine how gigantic is the role of the teacher in the community. Teacher may serve as a tutor, as a nurse, as guidance counselor, as a community leader, as resource speaker, as consultant, rolled into one. Indeed, society demands so much from a teacher with a very major salary. Joke lang. But compared to other profession, being a teacher, the salary of a teacher is quite already high compared to other profession. Yung mga nurse nga, napakababa ng sweldo ng nurse, and they are required to have the experience of volunteer. Before they'll be permanent, they have to volunteer. His or her title of a teacher is to teach well. That is what the society primarily demands. The primary duty of the teacher is to teach. The learning of the learner is our main concern. So the focus is on good teaching. You know, we always look for the result. We always look for the result. No matter is the process or the procedure, what is important is the desired outcome or the result. You have to be reminded that the ultimate goal of educating our children is to have them learn. To change their behavior. If there is a learning, you will know that there is a learning if there is a change in behavior. The research says that teacher is the single and the most important factor in the learner's learning. So it's the most important factor, the teacher. Because even though you'll have your class under the mango tree, if you have a fantastic, intelligent, well-motivated teacher, then I guess it will have a desirable result. But if a teacher, or even if you place a student in a conducive classroom, well-furnished, all the gadgets are there and the amenities are present, but there is no one to guide them, to facilitate learning, then although my learning might happen, pero it is not as what we desire. Okay? So, the most important factor in teaching learning process is the teacher. The effective teacher makes a good and not a good learner. On the other hand, ineffective teacher adversely affect the learning of both good and not so good student. So consider the following research findings shared by Dallas Public School Accountability System. What are the findings? Ang sabi ng Dallas Accountability System, learning gains realized by student during a year in a classroom of an effective teacher were sustained over later years and were compounded by additional years with effective teacher. So if you are a student and you will be under an effective teacher, the learning will be sustained even over later years. And you know for a fact that I know that you have your favorite teacher at hindi mo makakalimutan yung teacher na yun. And some of those teachers have inspired you. Some of those teachers have really influenced you where you are now. Right? So, we cannot discount the fact that a good teacher affects the student and may sustain that influence even through latter years. Okay? So conversely, a depressed achievement result in a resisted improvement even after student was placed in the effective teacher and the negative impact was discernible statistically for approximately 3 subsequent years. So even if the student will be placed in not so effective teacher, but the negative impact can be felt only after subsequently 3 years. So learning gains realized by students during a year in a classroom of an effective teacher were sustained over the latter years and were compounded by additional years with effective teachers. The negative effect of poor performing teacher and the student achievement persists through 3 years of high performing teachers. The good news is if the student have high performing teacher 1 year, they will enjoy the advantage of good teaching in the future. Conversely, if the teacher have low performance, if the student have low performance teacher, they will simply will not outgrow the negative effect of lost learning opportunity for the years to come. Okay, so according to John Brian Adams, teachers affect eternity. You can never tell where their influence stops. Okay? Teacher affects eternity. You can never tell where their influence stops. So if you will be under a good teacher, you will probably be a good student. And that will affect not only that year, but throughout the subsequent years. And we cannot also discount the fact that if you will be under a low performing teacher, it will have a subsequent effect even after the latter years. So what I am telling here, being a future teacher, you strive to become excellent, you strive to become a best teacher, because that effort of yours will influence, affect student performance, not only for that year, but even in the subsequent year. So clearly, teacher's impact on the learners lasts. The teacher is the key to student achievement. Teacher can make a student or can break a student. I don't know if you have experienced this, especially in mathematics subject. There are in our elementary and in our high school days, or even in the college days, there are years which we are under a teacher. There are years that we easily understood the concept of mathematics. And there are some other years na pupunta tayo sa mga teacher na hindi natin maintindihan yung pag-explain how they arrived the solution or how they arrived the answer. So, depende sa teacher. Naintindihan natin yung mathematics. It depends on the teacher. It depends on how he or she explains. Minsan, may mga taon na nahihirapan tayo. Paano ba intindihin ito? Hindi naman ini-explain ni ma'am. Mayroon namang mga taon na parang ang galing ko na sa math. Napakagaling ko sa math. Naintindihan ko na mathematics. So, that factor is attributable to the teacher. Okay? Then we move on to the topic, the teacher as a professional. So in a previous lesson, we have discussed that there are elements of profession, that is competence, because of the long years of study, and the code of ethics. Okay? So the code of ethics for professional teacher spells out the demands of the state, the community, the higher authorities, and the school officials, the parents from teachers. We will discuss this as we go along our course. And the code state clearly state what are the standards or the demands of the state, the community, higher authorities from teachers. So the word teacher suggests that the main responsibility of the professional teacher is to teach. Teachers is the primary customer. Teacher's primary customer is the learner. So let us concentrate on effective teaching, the professional teacher's primary responsibility. So our primary concern is to teach the learning of your student, the desired outcome, the academic performance. We do not care even if your classroom is so clean, even if your classroom is well ventilated, well fully furnished, and you have complete gadgets. If your student will not learn, you are not an effective teacher. But even if you have no classroom, but you deliver the goods, you have cause for the learning of your student, then you can say that you are an effective teacher. As I have said a while ago, it's the result that counts most. It's not the process. But as we have discussed, behaviorism, that learning is affected by the environment. So in order for you to cause learning, better academic performance for your students, you have to create a positive learning environment by having a classroom that is conducive for learning. Okay? So there are numbers of models or frameworks of an effective teaching. In the country, we have Philippine professional standards for teachers. The PPST are standards of good teaching. Formerly, it is called NCBTS, National Competency-Based Teaching Standards. But now, it is PPST, Philippine Professional Standards for Teachers. But before that, we go to PPST, we have to discuss first the models of an effective teaching. These are just models. It's not involve students in active spots such as student recognizing adherence to rules, procedures, establishment, maintaining an effective relationship with student, communicating high expectation for all students. Then next is the planning and prep preparing. So aside from knowing the strategies and the behaviors, you have also to plan and prepare. Planning and preparing for lesson, planning and preparing for technology, the needs of the student in receiving a special education, and the need of the student who lacks support for schooling. Then, after planning, reflection on teaching. So, as a good teacher, you have to evaluate personal performance, and you have to develop, implement, and monitor professional growth. Then, next is collegiality and professionalism. Promoting positive interaction with the colleagues, seeking mentorship of areas of interest, mentoring other teachers and sharing ideas, adhering to school's procedures, participating in the school's initiatives. So for Marzano, these are the four effective models of a teacher. For you to become an effective teacher, you have to check on the strategies and behaviors, you have to plan and prepare, you have to reflect on your teaching, and of course, you have to associate with your colleagues. Okay, and it includes professional growth and plan. So as a teacher, you do not stop learning after your bachelor's degree, after your units in education. You have to take graduate studies, master's degree, and doctorate degree. And even the PRC requires that, in continuing professional development, the CPD. Before you can renew your license, you have to present certificates of training and conferences, or your transcript for master's or doctoral degree. Okay, so we move on to Charlotte Danielson framework for effective teaching. So for Danielson, effective teacher must have his or her planning and preparation. He must create a positive classroom environment. And of course, he must be good in delivering the instruction and the professional responsibilities, which includes professional growth and development. So those are the four models according to Danielson. Then we move on to James Strong Teacher Effectiveness Performance Evaluation System, which includes letter C. James Strong Teacher Effectiveness Performance Evaluation System, or the TEPES, 7 performance standards. So for a teacher to become effective, he is measured of the following: his professional knowledge, his or her instructional planning, his or her instructional delivery, his or her assessment for learning, his or her learning environment, his or her professionalism, and also measured by student progress. Okay, but according to teacher evaluation standards, the MacRel model, or the Mid-Continental Resource for Education and Learning, for an effective teacher, for a teacher to be effective, the teacher must demonstrate leadership, lead in the school, lead in the teaching profession, advocate for school and student, demonstrate high ethical standard. Teachers establish respectful environment for diverse population, student. Teachers know the content they teach. Teachers facilitate learning for the student, and teachers reflect on their practice. But the PPEST has has spelled out the competence that is required for an effective teacher in the Philippines. This means that he or she has to teach effectively. He has to prepare and plan well for the instruction. Yes, you have your lesson plan and other preparation for instructional material. So before you go to your classroom, see to it that you have your well-written plan and your instructional materials, which might include the projector and the screen. Okay. Then, for a teacher to become effective, you have to execute and deliver the instruction plan very well, because he or she has a professional knowledge or mastery of the subject matter. So you do not only prepare for your technology, you also prepare yourself so that you can deliver the goods effectively. It means that you have the mastery of the subject matter. Then you create a conducive and favorable learning environment for diverse group of learners. You have to consider the individual differences. Then assess and report learners' progress. This is the role now of the assessment. And assessment provides feedback as to the performance of the student. So you cannot do away with the assessment. After delivering the goods, you have to assess. Then number 5, demonstrate professionalism as he or she deals with the superior colleague, student, and parents. During our first meeting, we have said that a teacher does not live alone. You need the help of your colleagues, you need the help of your superior, the parents, and the student. So, baguhin nyo yung behavior na the universe is, the center of the universe is you. You need to associate with your superiors. Yung iba, may mga teacher na inaaway yung kanilang superior. Ang iba naman, inaaway yung kanilang co-teacher. Sumisipsip sa kanilang mga superior para magawa nila yung inaaway nila yung kanilang mga co-teachers. Akala nila, pag inaaway, pag sumipsip sila, pag inaaway nila yung kanilang co-teacher at sumipsip sila sa superior, mapopromote sila. But it's not the way you have to do it. You have to make friends, not enemies. Okay? So, you just read the Philippine Professional Standards for Teachers. There are 37 domains, 37 strands, and 148 performance indicators. This PPSTA set the standards, the performance indicator of an effective teacher in the Philippines. It's a form of a checklist. Okay, so we move on to the next topic, professionalism, the hallmark of a professional. So are you now getting bored? Nagugutom na kayo? So let us just discuss this topic very quickly, because it's almost 1 o'clock and you'll have your next subject. So no doubt the society expects teacher as a professional to demonstrate professionalism in all that she or he do. Professionalism is both professional and a personal trait. According to the Code of Ethics, Section 7 of the Republic Act 4670 explains the professional conduct as it behoves every teacher to assume and maintain professional attitude to his work and dealing with his associates in the profession. It should be his self-imposed duty to constantly improve himself professionally. Criticism, when necessary, should clearly reflect friendly motivation and sincere desire to uphold the standard and dignity of the profession. In dealing with his or her pupils, the teacher should ever strive to be professionally correct, friendly, and sympathetic. So it is very clear in our code of ethics that as a teacher, we have to strive to become professionally correct. And even if we will have or throw criticism when necessary, it should only for the purpose of upholding the standards and dignity of the profession. Do not criticize a person personally, but the acts or the behavior in relation to his profession. That is how you criticize. Okay? So we move on to the next chapter, lesson 2, which is the demands of the society from teacher as a person. So you often hear the words, "I'm only a teacher." Teacher lang ako. O na, kung naalala niyo dati, may mga patalasta sa TV na mayroon, "Teacher lang ako, mangingisda lang po ako, magsasaka lang po ako." Sinabi, tanggalin mo yung lang. Dapat maging proud ka sa yung profession. O, teacher ako. Be proud that you are a teacher, because the future of your husband depend on you. Yun yung dati nakasulat sa mga gate. I remember I was still in elementary by the time of Secretary Ricardo Gloria in year 1996. Ganun. Alam nyo na yung edad ko ngayon, no? Yun yung nakasulat sa aming mga gate, sa pader. "Be proud you are a teacher. The future of the country depends on you." So, yung mga loko-loko naman binago nila, "Be proud you are a teacher. The future of your husband depend on you." Because at that time, maraming mga teacher na ang asawa nila ay mga tambay, at yung nakikita nila na mag-aahon sa kanila sa kahirapan ay yung teacher. Yan. Marami nga yung balhabal driver. I don't know the statistics, pero well, because after the graduation, pag wala ka pang girlfriend or boyfriend, after your graduation, your world will be limited. Bahay, paaralan. So, sino lang yung makikita mo na tao? Yung mga estudyante. At saka yung habal-habal driver. So, wala ka ng choice. Lalo-lalo na kung walang ibang nanliligaw sa'yo. Lumiliit ang yung mundo. Yan. So, teacher lang ako. This is what you usually hear from a teacher when he introduced himself or herself to a group of professionals. You know, there is a story, yung limang magkakapatid, sila ay tapos na lahat sa may kanya-kanyang profession. Tapos, isang gabi, their parents have invited them for a dinner. Unang dumating yung bunso na doktor. Wow, napakagara ng kotse. Sumunod yung engineer. Ganun din. Napakagara din ng kotse yung dala. Sumunod yung lawyer na kapatid. Ganun din, napakagara din ng coaching nila. Ang huling dumating ay yung teacher na naka-scooter, naka-motor, naka-motor cycle. Siya yung panganay. Pero ang istorya pala dyan, yung panganay, siya ang tumulong sa kanyang mga kapatid para maabot niya yung mga pangarap ng kanyang mga kapatid. So imagine that, mas mayayaman na ngayon yung kanyang mga kapatid. So siya, nagtitiis sa isang lumang motorsiklo, sa isang lumang motor. Samantalang yung kanyang mga kapatid ay mayayaman na. No? But he is proud because he helped his siblings to achieve their dreams. Kahit na siya ay teacher, pero doon naman yun ang kanyang ginamit para matustusan yung pangangailangan ng buong pamilya. While they are still on struggle. Ako ganun din naman. I cannot discount the fact that really teaching profession has helped me to where I am now. Nakatulong siya sa akin in terms of knowledge and in terms of finances and experience. So I'll not become a lawyer if I was not a teacher. It was a stepping stone for me. That's why I really love the teaching profession. Teachers are judged more strictly than other professionals. When a teacher fails to meet expectation of the public, like when she wears a ultra mini skirt or fails to pay the debt on time, the remark of scrutinizing eyes of the public is teacher pa naman din. So what are the demands of teacher profession from the teacher as a person? So this can be stated as personal qualities of teacher or attributes of teachers are demanded by the teaching profession, or what the personal trait a teacher must possess in order to function well as a professional teacher. So are you ready with your pen and with your paper? So the qualities of your favorite teacher may not be very far from one another. So let us compare these 12 characteristics of an effective teacher gathered from 15 longitudinal qualitative study. More than 1,000 pieces of teachers summarize the 12 characteristics of an effective teacher. What are those? Can you see my screen? Who will volunteer to read and explain? Volunteer? Arne Robles?
Sir, di ko makita, sir.
Ah, sino yung nakakakita ng mga characteristics?
Lucila, sir.
Ah, Lucila Balbarona.
Yes, sir. Number one characteristic is prepared.
It means?
The teacher should come to class each day ready to teach. Pag sinabi po natin ready to teach, dapat po, sir, yung teacher po is equipped, tapos tawag sini. Ready siya sa igka-klase sa mga kabataan.
Okay. So prepared, it includes a well-written plan and the classroom is already well arranged, the chairs are well arranged, you have there the technology, the projector or screen or the laptop if you are using the laptop. So you have to be reminded that an effective, the first characteristic of a teacher is being prepared. Next, who will volunteer and explain?
Sir, Jonathan po.
Ah, Jonathan.
Sir, number two, characteristic is positive.
Oh, what is that?
Positive, you have optimistic attitudes about teaching and about students. Siyempre, sir, pag pumasok ka sa campus or sa classroom, you have the kailangan mo kayong positive mindset, sir. Kung may da ka negative, yung mo mindset, magre-reflect ito, sir, sa iyo mag-teaching or mag-effect sa learners.
Okay. So, thank you.
No, sir.
Have a positive attitude, optimistic attitude about teaching and about the student. So it depends on your mindset and outlook in life. Always see the positive aspect out of the circumstances that you have. Okay, number three, who will volunteer? Sige, you're ready.
Hold high expectations. The teacher set no limit on students and believe everyone can be successful.
Okay.
So, sir, isa mga ano po, as a teacher, dapat sir, yung iintindihin mo yung estudyante mo na may improve pa siya, tapos makita mo yung learnings niya po and improvement.
Okay, so can you relate that to the video that we have watched on teacher Sabrina Onkiko? Ano yung kanya ginawa? She has set the goal. Ayan. She has set the goal for the students to achieve. And that goal should be high enough. Huh? Marami kasing mga teacher, especially in the barangay, they are limiting the students' achievement. Sinasabi nila na, ay, wala, hindi naman ito magpipresidente. Wala namang magiging mayor dito. Wala namang magiging abogado dito sa klase na to. So, hindi ko pagbubutihan yung aking pagtuturo. Parang, kung ano lang yung kanyang magawa, yung tinatamad siya sa pagtuturo kasi yun yung kanyang expectation. Wala namang magiging mayor, wala namang magiging professional, napakalayo. Hindi sinasabi ng mga ibang teacher, hindi nga magtatapos ng grade 6 yan. Pagkatapos ng grade 6, magiging tambay na yan, pupunta sa Maynila para magpaalila. Kaya bakit ko pagagalingan yung aking pagtuturo kung ganun din lang naman ang mangyayari, di ba? So they are limiting the expectation. They are limiting the achievements that the student might achieve in the future. Sige, next. Who else? Please volunteer. Creative. So, teacher are resourceful and inventive in how they teach their class. Yan. Hindi yung puro reklamo. Wala akong laptop. Wala akong supply ng bad paper, wala akong chalk, so hindi ako magtuturo ng maayos. Teacher should be creative and resourceful. You use your initiative. Gamitin mo kung anong mayroon ka. Pag-isipan mo and you'll come out with a desirable output. And of course, teacher must be fair. Handle the student and the grading fairly. Hindi porke na anak ni kumare, ni kumpare, mataas ang grade. So you must have your grading system set. Next, teacher should display a personal touch or he or she is approachable. Ayan. But you have also to set the limit and define your role being a teacher, because it is subject to abuse. If you do not put any boundary or wall between you and your student, it is subject to abuse. But you must be approachable. Okay? Cultivate a sense of belonging. We have to make feel the student they are welcome and comfortable in the classroom. So that is self-explanatory. Actually, Department of Education, during the opening of the classes, they are encouraging that the first to arrive in the classroom should be the teacher, and when the student arrives, they have to greet the student, good morning, welcome to the new school year. Dapat nandun siya mismo sa harap ng pintuan at siya ang unang makikita ng mga bata na sinasalubog sila ng smile, ng welcoming attitude, at sasabihin niyo, welcome to grade 7, welcome to grade 10, welcome to the new school year. Yun. Then, a teacher must also be compassionate, are concerned about the student's personal problem that can relate to them and to their problems. So, compassionate. You have to understand also your student. Have a sense of humor, of course. A good teacher have a sense of humor. Makes learning fun and do not take everything seriously. O, huwag magseryoso sa buhay kasi tatanda ka kaagad. Stress, maubusan ka ng buhok. Respect the student. Do not deliberately embarrass the student. Teacher who give highest respect, get highest respect. Yan. Respect begets respect. So even though they are just your student, you have to respect them. Then forgiving. Teachers do not hold grudges. Yun yung mahalaga. Alam nyo, mayroong mga teacher na parang gumaganti sa kanyang mga student in a form of grades. Binababaan yung grades, yung mark. Alam nyo, class, behavior is not for giving in low marks or grades to your student. It should not be a reason, because in giving academic marks or grades, the basis purely is just the academic performance. It does not include the attitude, does not include the character of the student. So if he or she deserves a high grade, even though he or he has not cultivate a positive attitude, you have still, he or he is still entitled to the grade that he or she deserves. Okay, next, admit mistakes. Quick to admit being wrong. Yan, yun yung maganda dapat sa teacher, admit mistakes. But as we observe, kadalasan sa atin, even with our friends or tayo mismo, we do not admit our mistakes. Nagtuturo tayo ng ibang tao. We are to blame. Sometimes we complain. Why are you poor? Because my parents are poor. Because of my situations. Well, not admit that we are poor because of our mistake. We do not. But according to some authors, if you start to admit your mistake, then it's the beginning of learning. It's the beginning of learning because you will know where you stand. And also in how to win friends and influence people, according to Dale Carnegie, the secret of winning friends is you admit your mistake. Kapag halimbawa, nakikiusap ka sa isang tao, halimbawa, meron kang kasalanan na ginawa, pinatawag ka ngayon ng boss mo. Immediately, sabi ni Dale Carnegie, so that you will really win the boss on your side immediately. If that's your mistake, then you admit that you are wrong. You ask for forgiveness. At mahihiya na lang yung boss mo. Hindi mo kasalanan. Hindi, sir. Sorry, kasalanan ko. Pero sabi ni Dale Carnegie, most of the time, the boss will not attribute that fault to you if you will immediately admit. Sasabihin ng boss mo, hindi kasi si ano dapat sisihin. Ano, hindi sir, ako ang dapat mong sisihin. Ganun din naman sa relationship, di ba? Boyfriend or girlfriend relationship o sa mag-asawa, naghihiwalay because they do not admit their own mistakes. If you admit your own mistakes, then there will be smooth sailing relationship. Ang hirap sa atin kasi hindi natin maamin sa sarili natin na may pagkakamali tayo, na tayo ay nagkamali. Tinuturo natin yung iba kay si ganito, siya kasi kung hindi lang niya ginawa ito, dapat ganito ang nangyari. But how about you? Do you admit your mistakes? You do not. Kaya nagkakaroon ng conflict. Okay, so those are the 12 characteristics of an effective teacher. Be prepared, positive, hold high expectation, creative, fair, display personal touch, cultivate sense of belonging, compassionate, have a sense of humor, respect students, forgiving, and admit mistakes. Okay, so that ends our discussion. Do you have any concern?